It's exhibition basketball here on ESPN. The Mavericks come in with a defense that just can't seem to create steals. They need a new approach and more dedication on the defensive end if they want things to change. They should find a tough matchup versus the Pacers, who come in playing steady on defense when it comes to forcing turnovers. They prefer to hold their spots on the floor rather than getting out of position. Let's go now to Bob Steele and Rod West, who are ready to call the game from Dallas, Texas.
Welcome, all you basketball junkies. We're here at the American Airlines Center in Dallas. I'm Bob Steele, and I'm here with my partner, Rod West. Let's take a quick look at the starters. Any thoughts, Rod?
I have to be honest with you, Bob. There isn't a lot of talent on these two starting lineups. I'm not sure who's going to rise to the challenge.
Rod, we'll see how it unfolds. The player introductions are about to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention courtside for the player introductions. First, for the Indiana Pacers, at center, Brad Miller. At forward, Ron Artest. At guard, Reggie Miller. Also at guard, Jamal Tinsley. Also at forward, Jermaine O'Neal. For your Dallas Mavericks, at center, from Kansas, 6'11", number 45, Ray Rodman. At forward, out of Seton Hall, 6'5", number 7, Adrian Griffin. The guard position, from Wisconsin, 6'7", number 4, Michael Finley. Also at guard, from Santa Clara, 6'3", number 13, Steve Nash. Also at forward, from Germany, 7 feet, number 41, Dirk Nowitzki.
The Pacers take the tip off to start the game. Artest wants it down low, in the paint, elevates. The first bucket of the game.
This is case in point of how important a drop step can be, Bob. Check out the replay.
Easy to see the effectiveness there. One step and then right to the hoop for the lay-in.
Love to see old school ball like that. Love it.
Nowitzki throws it in.
Low.
Passes.
Curl 89. Push back.
Spins to the hoop. Gets stopped by Tinsley. Goes with the crossover. With the jab step. Puts up the shot.
Just wide open on the outside. I'll tell you, it's all about fundamentals after that. Set, spot, release, and follow it through.
Lobbed. Takes the turnaround, Jay. Bounces it off the left rim, then in.
Man, he is just deadly with that shot. Easy deuce.
Just over 4 minutes here in the first quarter. Nowitzki launches from beyond the arc.
Nowitzki didn't have to rush that three because no one was near him. He just zoned in and let it fly.
Just under 4 minutes here in the first quarter.
Up down low.
Tinsley dishes it off. They're inside. They work it in. 7 seconds to shoot. The jumper was buried by O'Neal.
O'Neal set up right inside and finished the play with no one around him.
Nowitzki wants the ball. It unloads from about 20 feet out.
It's
the kind bounce off the back rim.
Finley didn't like what he saw there at first, so he gives a little pump fake to get a better look.
It works like a charm here, too. And after the fake, just lines up for the J and drops it in, Rod.
Miller
inbounds the ball.
The Pacers
have the ball in a small deficit, 7-6.
Get him. Watch the pick. Stay in, stay in.
Inside. Fires from the post. Answers right back.
The defender really had his work cut out for him there. Against a superb inside guy like that, you've got to bring your big game.
Just over 3 minutes here in the first quarter. Passes it. Uses the crossover. Jabs. Puts it up. Off the back. Michael rim by Finley.
Doesn't mind taking that outside shot, especially when nobody's covering it.
The Pacers
work it up court. They're shooting 100% from the floor.
Miller
passes the ball.
O'Neal
shoots, gets the go-ahead bucket.
Man, he is just in his element inside. What a player.
Get him.
The Mavericks
have the rock. They're four out of their last four from the floor. Passes.
Finley puts it up from a step inside the line and gets it to fall. He's money from there.
Boy, that's a tough spot to be in against a shooter of his caliber. You've got to bring your all if you want to shut him down.
Just over 2 minutes here in the first quarter. The three ball was dropped in by Miller.
He is just brutal on the defense from the three-point land, Bob. Truly one of the great shooters in this league.
Just under 2 minutes here in the first quarter. Passes it. Finley goes with the fadeaway. Drains the lightly contested shot.
Michael!
Finley comes clean right off that pick, and it was pretty simple after that.
Offense just doesn't get any more basic than that, but it works.
Miller
with the inbound.
Ball, ball.
Tinsley makes the pass.
Miller launches from beyond the arc. Miller from the arc gets two from downtown.
They made a mistake right there. You cannot leave an NBA guy that open from beyond the arc. Even some of the big guys going to hit that shot.
Passes.
Finley gets airborne. Gets the bucket and the foul. He'll go to the line for one more.
Finley is doing everything he can to keep his team in the game, Bob. You've got to love it when the player digs down deep and carries
the Mavericks.
Finley will come back in the game. The Pacers
head into the front court. They're shooting 100% from the arc.
Artest
has it.
Help down low.
Bounce pass.
Seven on the shot clock. Miller hands it and gets his 11th point of the game.
Bad matchup for the D there, Bob. They're giving up way too many inches inside.
51 seconds here in the first quarter.
Watch the screen. Push, push by.
Gets busy.
Goes glass in the lane.
Nice.
Miller
throws it in.
The Pacers would love to extend their lead this trip down.
Tinsley passes. They push it inside.
Miller
takes a turnaround Jay. Gets the bucket and the foul. He'll go to the line for one more.
Excellent concentration here. Takes the jumper, gets hit, and still manages to drop in the bucket. Great play.
You gotta be strong to make a play like that.
Hey, defensively, you never want to foul a jump shooter. Challenge it aggressively, but don't bail him out and hurt your own team by giving up the bucket and the foul.
He completes the three-point play.
The Prince
will come off the floor. Our task will head to the bench. The Mavericks
have it. They're shooting 100% from the floor.
Nowitzki has position down low. Dirk Nowitzki releases from the stripe. Bounces this one way out there, then through. Miller
inbounds the ball.
The Pacers
bring it up. They're three out of their last three from the arc. Tinsley rises up, gets the lay-in.
Tinsley.
The Mavericks
have the ball. They're six out of their last six from the floor.
And
up in time, the buzzer beaters stand by Nash.
We're at the end of one. The score,
24-23.
The Mavericks
trail single digits after one, Rod. Any significant stats that leap out at you?
Assist, Bob. Their offense is bogging down way too much in one-on-one situations, and teammates are not getting set up and aren't setting each other up. They need to create some more opportunities for each other like they've shown they can do from time to time.
Get him!
Launches from beyond the arc. Dang. He's now hit double figures.
That's an old basketball move, but the pump fake, still good.
Especially when you're able to knock down the open jumper on a consistent basis. O'Neal with the inbound. Passes it.
Watch the screen.
Skies. Set on the reverse.
Tinsley wasn't satisfied with just dunking the ball. He did it with some style.
Nash has the ball. He's four out of his last four from the floor. Takes the quick shot. Picks up his fifth point of the quarter. He has a total of 12 so far.
You'll sink those all day, Bob. What a nice shot.
The Pacers can tie it up with a basket this trip down. Tinsley passes it. Launches from beyond the arc.
Miller
creates a three. He's got 4 3-pointers tonight.
Miller found the soft spot in the defense. They weren't guarding him on that shot at all.
Nash is at the controls. He's shooting 100% from the floor. Nowitzki takes a wide open shot.
Nice job to get open and drain that outside shot.
Tinsley works it up court. He has 4 points from the paint. Passes. Puts it up. Rod, break that down for me on replay.
Miller
didn't like what he saw there at first, so he gives a little pump fake to get a better look.
It works like a charm here, too. And after the fake, just lines up for the J and drops it in, Rod. Nowitzki throws it in. Nash has the rock. He's 5 of 5 from the floor. The steal.
The Pacers
are at the controls. They're shooting 100% from the arc.
5 under 2.
Tinsley dishes it off. In low.
7 seconds to shoot.
O'Neal shoots from the top of the key. Gets the kind bounce off the back rim.
Pretty good from there, Bobby. Great release.
Just under 3 minutes here in the second quarter.
Pick him up.
Into the low post. It's stolen!
The Pacers can extend their lead this trip down. They'd love to do that.
Puts it up from a step inside the line. Tinsley
is credited the assist. That's his fifth. I thought the D would have shut that one down in a hurry, but never underestimate this guy. He gets the job done.
Now by Van Exel. Goes with the crossover.
Nick Van Exel elevates.
Goes glass in the lane.
Watch the book right here, Bob. One thing to remember, this is a physical game.
Physical is right. Real impressive that he got that shot off and laid it in.
O'Neal
inbounds the ball.
Pick him
the
up.
Pacers
work it up court. They're shooting 100% from the floor.
2C, 2C.
Passes it.
Line it up, line it up.
Miller goes with a fadeaway. Thinks his 20th point of the game.
Defense has to get a body on him out there. Make him think twice before he takes that shot.
Nash has it. He's 2 out of his last 2 from the arc. Fires. Drops in his 14th point tonight.
Boy, that's a tough spot to be in against a shooter of his caliber. You've got to bring your all if you want to shut him down.
The Pacers have the rock. They're 4 out of their last 4 from the arc.
O'Neal
passes the ball. Stolen.
Perfect timing of the double team, Bob. You can look it up if you don't believe me. They trapped down low, the man had nowhere to go, and the defense came away with the steal. That's what they wanted.
Nash has the basket and has 9 points so far this quarter. Has a total of 16 so far.
The Pacers
head into the front court. They're 6 out of their last 6 from the floor.
Blair, Blair.
Passes. Takes a wide open shot.
Banks it in.
Tinsley is such a double threat. He can use that crossover to take the ball to the rim or pull up on you just like he does here.
Rod, how long has that move been around?
Bobby, the crossover move has been around since the late 60s, though most NBA fans think it's something that Tim Hardaway or Allen Iverson invented.
Nowitzki with the inbound. Nash has the ball. He has 16 points from the floor.
15, go. Double down.
Gets airborne.
Switch. Double off.
Nowitzki from the arc. That's two from downtown. The three-point shot is his forte, and of course, he nails that one. Bob, you've got to watch him close out there in the outskirts.
43 seconds here in the second quarter. Tinsley makes the pass. In the paint.
O'Neal
uses the leaner inside. Gets the far iron, but it goes in.
That's where his talent lies. Those inside shots, just like that. Get him the ball, keep getting him the ball.
Nash is at the controls. He's six out of his last six from the floor. Takes a turnaround, Jay. Gets the bucket and his seventh point this quarter. He has a total of 12 so far.
Nash learned a long time ago that it doesn't matter who scores, it just matters that someone scores. He's just happy with dishing out the assist.
Tinsley works it up court. He has 4 points from the paint.
Miller buries the three-pointer. He's had five of those fall for him tonight.
What an assist. He's got such court vision that he can always find the open man. And he's unselfish enough that he'll dish it off to a guy who's got the best chance of making the bucket.
The clock runs out, and we're heading to the half. The score, 44-44.
Let's throw it to Clark in the studio for a quick halftime recap.
Welcome to this playoff edition of the ESPN Halftime Update. Let's break down the numbers from the first half. The Mavericks have been hitting the three ball with ease out there in the first half. Their outside shot is keeping them in this game, so I expect to see more of the same in the second half. Reggie Miller, in the first half, has a total of 23 points. He'll walk away with our Sega Sports Hot at the Half player. That's our halftime report. Make sure to tune in to the ESPN postgame show at the conclusion of the game. Let's send it back to Bob and Rod.
Substitution for the Mavericks.
Substitution for the Mavericks. Nash
puts it up from a step inside the line.
Just picked up number 21 with that bucket.
Simple but effective pump fake gets him enough room to bury the J. That's a clever move.
I figured you'd like this play, Rod. He just nails the shot after shaking his man loose with a nice pump fake.
You figured me right, Bob. Call me old-fashioned, but a simple, effective move to get to the bucket, he can't bucket.
Pick him up. I got him. Move. Nice.
The Pacers, with the score of this trip down, can tie it up.
Turn for five.
Miller
passes.
Tried to get all fancy-schmancy with that crossover, but the D played him straight up and drew the foul. That's heads-up defense, Bobby.
Nowitzki is asking for it in the post.
From three-point range up in the Mavericks drop another one from downtown, and from the looks of things, if they keep putting the ball up, it might be enough to put them ahead for good.
Passes it. Tries to spin move. It's stopped by Finley. They're inside.
Miller
pulls the trigger from the high post.
Miller
gets nothing but net.
Miller is normally pretty harmless when it comes to the drop step, but not this time.
Rod, when you have limited post-up skills, you know it's going to come down to your jumper.
You're right, Bob. He didn't have enough to get up to the rim. Who cares? A jumper and a layup, they both count the same.
Nowitzki
inbounds the ball.
Nash, if he gets a three this trip, he'll have 4 3-pointers on the night.
Fires.
Drops in his 14th point tonight.
Inside, outside, Bob. He suckers the defense inside, then he kicks it out for the beautiful assist to the open man.
The Pacers bring it up.
They're shooting 100% from the floor. The alley was pooped in by Artest.
Nice assist. That was a tough pass to make, but he got it inside to the open man. Good job.
Finley heads up court. He's 6 of 6 from the floor.
Nash drains number 23.
Nash is pumped right now. He's trading his shots and his team should just keep riding.
The Pacers
have the ball. They're 5 out of their last 5 from the arc. Tinsley with the pass, and he's got 9 assists tonight.
That was an outstanding alley-oop pass. Not only was the positioning dead on, but the timing was just perfect. They couldn't help but jam that bad boy down.
Nowitzki is looking for the ball. How that nice jumper by Nash.
Didn't like what he saw there at first, so he gives a little pump fake to get a better look.
It works like a charm here, too. And after the fake, just lines up for the J and drops it in, Rod.
Miller with the inbound.
Tinsley.
With an assist here, he'll have 10 assists on the night.
High rises. Gets the lay-in.
There's the 1% chance right there. That is one lucky shot.
Nash has it. He's 3 of 3 from the arc.
Nash
passes it. Releases. Bounces it off the short side.
He's going to try it all night long if that's the kind of token defense they plan to put up against him.
Tinsley.
With a bucket here, he can get his 10th point of the game.
Lobbed it.
7 on the shot clock.
Puts it up inside. Answers right back.
O'Neal
acts like he's going to drive it after making the drop step, but then he stops on a dime and pulls up for the sweet check.
Rod, that's so impressive when a player can change his momentum that quickly and still drain the jumper.
Hey, you never know when you're going to have to switch gears. The good players are always ready to put up the rock.
LaFrance
throws it in.
Nash
brings it up.
He's shooting 100% from the arc.
Passes.
Finley launches from beyond the arc. Gets back iron and out.
Finley is too wide open if there is such a thing. I think he choked a little bit on that before.
The Pacers are at the control. They're 6 out of their last 6 on the floor.
Tinsley dishes it off. Uses the crossover. Gets cut off by Nash. Passes it.
Rafe LaFrance shoots from the top of the key.
Gets it to fall. He's running from there.
The Mavericks drop another one from downtown, and from the looks of things, if they keep putting the ball up, it might be enough to put them ahead for good.
Lob low post. O'Neal gets a 6 point of the period. He's got 14 total.
O'Neal just wasn't satisfied with laying the alley-oop in. He jammed it home to send a message.
Finley is at the controls. He's 1 out of his last 2 from the arc.
Pass low post. They work it in. They push it inside.
7 seconds to shoot. LaFrance now has it.
Right, here's a second look.
That's an old basketball move, but pump fake, still good.
Especially when you're able to knock down the open jumper on a consistent basis.
O'Neal
inbounds the ball.
The Pacers can cut into the lead with a basket here.
Tinsley passes the ball. He goes with the fadeaway. Of course, his 8th point of the period. He has a total of 16 so far.
The Pacers continue to work the ball around with incredible efficiency. Teamwork like this is beautiful to watch.
Passes.
I got him.
Finley unloads from about 20 feet out. Drops in his 16th point of the game. You'll sink those all day, Bob. What a nice shot.
9 seconds here in the third quarter.
Launches from beyond the arc. Kisses it off the right rim, then in. We've just finished the third quarter. The score,
63-61.
The Mavericks
still cling to a small lead going into the fourth. What's been the key stat so far, Rod?
3-point shooting, Bob. The shooting numbers between these two teams aren't even close. They need to forget about those threes and concentrate on maintaining this lead.
O'Neal
with the inbound.
O'Neal wants it down low.
In low. Passes outside. Kickback in the paint.
7 on the shot clock.
They're inside.
O'Neal
takes a turnaround J. Ties it up.
He's just so quick, Bob. He abuses the defender with the drop step move and gets the bucket.
This guy is so hard to stop with that move, Rod. Great defensive anticipation is a must to slow him down.
Completely true, Bob. If the defense can stay with him and put a hand in his face, they'll have a much better chance of stopping him.
Nash has the rock. He's 6 out of his last 6 from the floor. Now left wing.
Out, out.
Launches from beyond the arc. Brings it.
Nice assist. He gets the ball inside, then the defense has to close ranks. Then he just kicks it back to the outside man. Good job.
Tinsley heads up court. He has 6 points from the paint.
Up down low.
Bounce pass.
O'Neal shoots. Sinks his 20th point of the game.
Jamal Tinsley is as cool as ice, and he is not melting under the pressure in this close game. You have to love a guy this heady calling the shots when the momentum is swinging either way.
The jumper was buried by LaFrance.
The Mavericks drop another one from downtown, and from the looks of things, if they keep putting the ball up, it might be enough to put them ahead for good.
Miller makes the pass. Miller gets busy, dunks it down with both hands.
Miller made his mind up early that he was going with the flush.
Nash, if he gets a three this trip, he'll have 4 3-pointers on the night.
Received by Finley. Pass to the paint.
Nowitzki was camped in the lane there, and he gets the 3 second call. Artest
throws it in.
Artest wants the ball. Pulls the trigger from the high post.
Miller
takes the lead.
Miller gets the bucket here, but I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't say something about that great pass.
I'll say, Rod, the key was when he went up for the jumper and then drew the defense to him.
Hey, bingo. Once he had the defense's attention, he dished it for the easy score.
The Mavericks have the rock.
They're shooting 96% from the floor. Passes it.
Uses the crossover.
Puts up the shot.
Mavericks can't break this game up. It's a little scary. This is anybody's contest at this point.
Tinsley brings it up. He's 5 of 5 from the floor. Lobbed.
Miller gets his 6th point of the period.
Miller.
He's got 9 in the game.
Tinsley dropped the ball right inside to pick up the assist. Shot percentages are so low for some players today because they're always thinking shoot first and pass second. Great offenses always use the reverse velocity.
Passes. Uses the leader inside.
Money! He's got 18 tonight.
It's always tougher to hit a jumper while you're moving.
He shows perfect concentration and control and knocks it down.
Artest
inbounds the ball.
The Pacers have it.
They're 6 out of their last 6 on the floor.
O'Neal
has position down low.
Launches from beyond the arc. Reggie from outside.
Reggie.
He's just scored his 6th 3 of the game. The Mavericks have a big opportunity and can tie it up here. Nash takes a quick shot. Gets the bucket and now has 27.
Nash has the adrenaline pumping. He's feeling real good right now because everything is falling for him.
Tinsley
on this trip can get assist number 15. Miller
is asking for it in the post.
Miller, count it. He now has 30.
Miller puts it in yet again. And if he keeps this up, he just might be the difference maker tonight.
LaFrance with the ball. Rises up.
Gets fouled and makes the bucket. We'll have an opportunity to add one at the charity stripe.
This is a big-time bucket right here. Check this move out. He makes contact there, and then he manages to get the shot off. Good job.
Great body control as he managed to pretty much ignore the hack and still sink it.
Bobby, you know they're happy to have this guy shooting the ball, but if he chokes it, it could very well cost him the game. He yanks it down inside. Skies!
Hits the bucket, and his 7 point this quarter. He has a total of 23.
The Mavericks lighting up the Nets tonight. If they can find a way to create some more shot opportunities while staying on this streak, chances are they'll start to pull away here.
Miller launches from beyond the arc. Buries his 33rd point of the game.
Miller is doing everything he can to keep his team in the game. And with accuracy like that, you can bet they'll look to him down the stretch.
58 seconds in the game.
Steve Nash nails the basket and now has 29. The Pacers have a chance to take the lead here late in the fourth.
Tinsley passes.
We got to see that again.
Miller is fearless, Bob. He knew he was going to get banged. He knew he might not get the call. He did not care.
That's what it takes to go inside and finish strong in the NBA.
They can go 2-for-1 here if they want, Bob. Let's see how they manage the clock.
The Mavericks will take a timeout here. Griffin
with the inbound. Passes it.
LaPrince goes up.
Answers right back with a dunk of his own.
Timeout, Pacers.
Shoots off the inbound. Now has 10 points this period. He has a total of 35.
Timeout, Mavericks.
Shoots off the inbound. Gets it, and he's got 31 for the game.
Nash didn't like what he saw there at first, so he gives a little pump fake to get a better look.
It works like a charm here, too. And after the fake, just lines up for the J and drops it in, Rod.
Three-point play. Nash has the rock. He's three out of his last three from the arc. Nash passes it. Takes off. It's blocked.
You've got to love the protection right there. That's how you play the game. Makes this old coach proud. You can usually count on this guy to make his free throws, Bob. But if he fails to take the ball here, he leaves his team very vulnerable to their opponents.
He gets the first of two. Nash heads up court. He has 9 points from the arc. Nash launches from beyond the arc. Gets right iron. No good. He gets the first of two. Second. Defensive rebound by Nowitzki. Nowitzki has it. He's six out of his last six from the floor. Nash unloads from deep, deep three-point range. Nash drains the three. That's his fourth from beyond the arc tonight.
Using picks like this is essential for a jump shooter. He gets enough space and knocks down the shot.
You know, every college coach in America talks about fundamentals like this, and it's great to see it at the NBA level.
O'Neal
inbounds the ball.
Nowitzki with the personal.
That's his first foul of the game.
He can't get the first. He sinks the second.
They need to get a three here to send it into overtime.
And that'll do it. Your final score for tonight's game,
90-87. And that will finish it up for us. Be sure to tune in to SportsCenter to catch the latest news, scores, and highlights. Check your local listings for the correct time and channel. That's on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.